Hey everyone, welcome back to Silverrun Forest. So we're picking straight up more or less from where we finished off last time. So we're going to continue clearing the trees out along the edge of this grass field. I've already got a few out that I've used with the John Deere skidder. And I've cleared up all the offcuts that we had lying around as well. They're stacked up in a pile over that side. So what we're going to do is, as I said, continue clearing out the trees on the land we own, which is pretty much up to that track that you can just about see on the minimap. And we're going to cut them down with the chainsaw and then use the John Deere skidder to drag the trees down onto the flat area where we can then get them processed. So I've been cutting these ones at 90 degrees. So as I mentioned in one of the earlier episodes when I was doing this, I used the degrees of rotation that shows on the minimap to get that to 90 or as close as, and then we'll cut the tree so they all fall in the same direction, which does make it a little bit easier when you're then dragging them out. They're all the same way. So I've gone around and marked quite a few of the trees. I may have missed a few. That one's a deadwood tree. There's a mark on this one. So we'll do the same on this, 90 degrees. So it doesn't need to be perfect as long as it's somewhere close to 90. They'll fall pretty much in the right direction and be nice and parallel to each other, assuming they don't bounce like that off the go flying. I did have one tree that did go flying quite far as it fell down. I will get this one as well. So yeah, the plan for today is to finish off getting all these trees cleared out of this section, and then I want to try and get the new fields plowed in, and then next month we'll skip through to October then. And then we can get the one of the fields planted with barley. I don't know if we'll plant both fields with crops, this like winter crops, or whether we'll leave one field. I don't know why I'm delimbing the tree. I don't need to. Force of habit. Yeah, so we'll, if we jump in the John Deere skidder, and then we can back this up, get the winch attached to these, and then we can drag them down. We still need to get the fuel on the processor topped up, because we are running low on that. So if we go to the back, and then you can access the winch with R or pressing the left analog stick. So if we see if there's a tree nearby that we can drag down, the one close to this one. This is one of the other trouble as well, is can we get a bit difficult to see where all the trees are. So I don't think there is another one, so we'll attach that one on. I can drag that one down. So it's just literally going to be a case of doing this, but we can pull up to at least four fully grown trees with this. So we drop that one off somewhere there. Get that disconnected. Now I need to go tree hunting. I can see the end of one just sticking through the trees there. So we come around this way, we may be able to find that one a bit easier. So there's a few up there, so if we park that there, again we'll go to the back and pick up the winch. And I think there's a couple over here we might be able to drag over. Reconnect that one. And then with the Xbox controller, if you by the winch and press the analog stick, I don't think that one's going to be the best one to get actually. So we'll take that one off because I think there's too many trees there. So we can get those two together, we'll have to come back up. So we'll go for this one first. Maybe we'll cut down, yeah, we'll cut down this one as well. I think there's another one. So we'll get that one to 90-ish. And we'll cut this one down, get rid of that stump. And I think there's another one just here as well we can do. Oh, I want to cut that tree in half. Get that stump out as well. And yeah, we'll do this one as well while we're here. I should be able to drag all four of those trees down. The John Deere's got a winch weight of maximum weight of 15 tons, which most of these trees are. Bring up the help window. We go up to the tree. Yeah, that one's just under 4 ton for the one tree. So some of them are around about 3, 3.5, depending on the actual tree. That one's only 1.3, so yeah, we should be able to pull 4. We'll get rid of that one. And we'll go and get the winch. I'm not sure how far this will extend, so hopefully it'll get this tree up here. Yeah, we want that one. If we connect that one. Bring up the help window. Yeah, for some reason it's not. Oh, there we go. Maybe I'm a little bit too far away to get it to. Oh no, it's working now. So we can control the winch and we can drag this one down a little bit until we get some there, and then we can. Oh, can't quite get that one. A little bit too far away. How about that one? Nope. I've exceeded the. So we might have to drag that one down a little bit further and then come back for the other two. We don't get caught on that tree. So we'll drag this one down to the skidder, or a little bit closer. Actually, we'll stop that there. Disconnect that. And if we get the next tree, connect that one. Yeah, we've gone a little bit too far on the. Oh, we can get that one now. So if we bring that one down a little bit more, just so we're kind of close to the end of that one, and then we can connect both up and then drag both of those down together. And we should be able to get these both roughly where the end of this tree is. And then should be able to connect all three up. Yeah, still not letting us get that one. What might need to do is. Still saying max winch rope reached. We're not that far away now. Yeah, we'll need to just drag these down and then connect up these other ones separately. Right, so let's disconnect those two and then get the winch again. Just connect up to that one. Drag that one down again. So it can be a bit finicky to do this. I'm just wondering whether it is actually any quicker, but and then we'll get that one. So winch again, connect to this one, control this one down. And they're all fairly close now, so we should be able to get all four connected up. So we go, no, that one. I don't know, it's the same max winch rope. And we are literally just there. Right, let's connect that one first. And that one. That one. There we go. Now we've got all four on there. And you'll be able to just drag these through these trees, hopefully, without getting caught up. There we go. And we can just drop these off sort of in line with the others. And then we can just come along with the processor and process all these. So that's basically all we're going to be doing is taking out all the big trees along here, dragging them down to the grass. and then we can get them processed on the flat area. So I'm going to continue getting the rest out, or as many as I can, and then we can come back and get them all, start getting them processed once we've got the processor refueled. Okay, so I think we've got the last three trees to drag down. So we've got quite a few that we've dragged out now into this area. We'll get those ones disconnected and we can get this moved out of the way. So what we need to do next is go and get some way of refueling the actual Volvo tree harvester. Okay, so we'll go and buy the fuel tanker. I think the one I'm going to get, I'm not sure which category it come under, maybe trailers. Yeah, we'll get the one that goes with the TLX 2020. So this is the liquid IT trailer. I think we'll change the main colour for red. I'll keep the rest as standard. Actually, we'll put the fenders on and we'll buy that. So it's 19,500. But we are probably going to get a lot more use out to this now with all the forestry equipment we're starting to get. So as we move around the map, we're going to have to refuel on the go. I could also do refuel in the John Deere, actually. So we'll head over to the gas station and get this filled up. Okay, so I've got some fuel in the tanker, not quite filled it up as it took forever just to get to 20%. So I only put 5,000 litres in, which will be enough for now. I say, I'd have been sat there for another half an hour, probably waiting to fill the rest of it. So hopefully this should be able to refuel. I can never remember which way around you have to have this tanker to get it to fill from. I think we need to open it as well. There we go. So there's our Volvo tree harvester refueled. So we'll get that closed, unfolded, and park this out of the way. The engine switched off, so we're not burning fuel in that. So we'll get the processor headed in the horizontal position. We want to go that way around. Yeah, so what we'll do, we'll just go along the actual row of trees now, get them processed. We'll do 6 meters again. And then we can load them up onto our logging trailer. So I do like the fact that when you pick up the tree now, it does set it back to the end of the tree. So it'll move it back to the end of the tree. So it doesn't matter where you pick up the tree. It'll always like go to the end first and then cut from there. So we'll just go through, we'll do 6 meters. I'll keep out the shorter top bits as well. We'll keep those separate, same as last time, make it a little bit easier to keep them separate. So the top bits we'll just throw over to the side as we go along. So yeah, we'll continue getting all these processed. As I say, I'll show you now, just you don't have to pick it up towards the end. You can literally pick up the tree anywhere. So as soon as you get it in position and press A to actually get the tree, he says it's not going on. Come on. There you go. It'll feed it through to the end of the tree and then cut from there. So say you don't have to worry about trying to pick up the very end. Okay, so let's get all these processed, which is going to be a lot of money's worth once we get all these cut down, sold. We'll probably will take at least one load up to the old sawmill, but I'll leave that to probably the final load because it may be just a partial one, and then we can top that up. last few trees to cut up and process, and then that'll be all of this done. There is a few more trees just going over in that direction on in between the road and here that we could potentially cut down, but there is a fairly flat area the other side of the stream that we can get those. As for the processing, it's going fairly well. It is a bit tricky to pick up some of the trees when they're really close together. The harvester head is like really weak when it comes to moving trees. So where you've got two like this, where they're bunched right up together, it can be a bit tricky to get it to pick up. Sometimes it'll do that even though you're not down on the tree, it will actually pick the tree up, and then other times it just won't. So there's been a few that I've had to fiddle around with to get them to pick up, but on the whole it's not been too bad. So we'll get this last one after this process. And then what we'll do, we'll go around with the skidder and then use the blade on that to try and neaten up the stacks a little bit and then make it a little bit easier for loading. So last one. And then we'll just go around and I'll collect up all the offcuts off the end pieces. So we'll finish with this, so we'll get this put over here out the way. And then we'll jump in the skidder. There's quite a lot of trees there. I think there's probably, two, three full loads on the trailer. Maybe even more than that. So there's potentially 300,000-400,000 in logs there. So yeah, a lot of money's worth. Or potentially anyway. So get the blade load down. So we'll just do the same as we did last time. I'll push them into fairly neat piles, and then that makes it a little bit easier to pick up with the wheel loader. Try and push some of these out the way as well. What I may have to do is just go around and do like one stack, load it up, and then push up the rest, because I can't get into those now to do that. So we jump in the wheel loader and we'll get that stack, and it'll be a case of just loading, pushing the logs together and then loading as we go along. This is one of those jobs where you're really good in multiplayer, because you could have one person cutting the trees down, one skidding them down, another person processing, one loading. There we go, there's the first stack on. So yeah, what I'll do is I'll just continue now. I'll push the piles together, load up a bit, push the piles together, load up a bit, until we've got a full trailer load. Right, last load of logs to go on this trail load, and then we'll get this one sold. Hopefully we can fit these ones on without making a mess of them. Just about, I think we'll leave it at that. I don't want to try and struggle to put any more on or risk knocking the trailer over. So yeah, we've still got quite a lot. There's definitely another full load, and then probably a partial load which we could take up to the old sawmill, and then it'll be a case of trying to get these new fields plowed in. So let's get those strapped down. I think the best price for loose wood is still Elm Creek, so that would mean loading it to the train. So we may just take it to the safe sawmill again. So we'll go wood. Actually, the paper factory is not too bad. It's actually higher than the safe sawmill. So we'll take this load to the paper factory. Which is going to be a nice drive down that dirt track. There's no main road to the paper mill. So I think we'll have to go up here, do a right down that dirt track, and then hopefully we won't get stuck or get to a point where it's going to cause us any issues. Okay, so I've no idea where the trigger is, so we'll have to just switch on the interactive zone markers. Also, I don't know if this will take the full load. I don't know what the storage capacity is on the actual sawmill. So turn on interactive zone markers first. And then work out, so there's an unload point down the middle there, which I don't know if we'll actually get to. Pallet spawn point looks like it's there on the back. Yeah, the trigger to unload is just on the side there as well. Yeah, this is going to be a bit of a tricky place to get into, so we might have to see if we can get round here and then reverse back. I don't think we're going to get in this way. Right, let's see if we can come to the other side of that tree and then reverse back into there. It looks like you're better off coming down that ramp and then straight into this place. So if you can see, only just about fit. I think we're actually stuck now on that log at the back. So let's get this sold. Oh, I think that's it. So 35,000, it didn't take a lot. So I presume the storage of wood for the paper mill is now full. So I said the next, right, I think other than Elm Creek, the only other place we can take it is the actual safe sawmill, without loading it onto the train or put it into a container. So sawmill's the best current price, so we could take it there, or we could take this up to the old sawmill and just top that up. Okay, so I took the rest of the logs up to the old sawmill, and that's now up to 101,000 or so. So we don't need to worry about topping that up again just yet. Just double check. Yeah, so old sawmill, 109,000 now, all the rest of the logs. So that's actually completely filled up, the old sawmill. So the next load we'll just take to sell. I don't know if we'll get another full load after that. Don't quite think there's enough there, but there may be, we'll see. So I'm going to continue getting the rest of these all loaded up, because I do want to get this area cleared now so we can get these new fields plowed in. The offcuts I may just stack up. I'm really tempted to at some point get a wood chipper, and we can start just wood chipping these as we go. So I'll get like a marble wood chipper, because wood chips are worth quite a bit in the winter. So yeah, I'm going to continue. I'll get the next load loaded up if I can get the grab to open. There we go. For some reason it wasn't working. I've already tidied up the piles with the skidder, so they're all fairly neatly stacked. So it's just a case of getting them all loaded up, and then we can get these ones sold. So, and then get these two new fields plowed in. So we've got another trailer load that we'll take over to the safe sawmill, and there's still a fair bit left there, but I don't think there's quite another trailer load, but it should be a fair bit. I don't know if we can get into the safe sawmill this way. I didn't notice this gap in the fence before. Although I don't think we'll be able to get across the train line. Yeah, it doesn't look like there's any way across. So we'll have to go the long way around. Let's see how much we make for this load. In the last one we got, was it 91,000 or so? I can't remember how much it was in the last episode. I don't think there's quite as many of the new trees on here. I think there's a bit more spruce on this one, but we'll soon see. But 89,715, so a little bit less than the one we got last time. But still not too bad. So up to 240,000. So I'm going to go and load the rest of the logs up and get those sold, so they're completely cleared off the field. This is the last of the logs. I also cut down a few more trees just over there. You might be able to see the tree harvester. There's a small patch of lodgepole pines that I've cleared just on that corner as well, just to finish filling up the trailer. So we've pretty much almost got a full trailer load again. So we'll get this sold, and then the next job will be to get the two new fields plowed in. So 97,572 for that load, so just below 100,000. Takes up to 338,496. Some of that money we're going to have to use to probably buy another area of land, as the trees we planted on the area of land up by the old sawmill are still growing, and we've pretty much cleared all the trees we're going to get off that area of land. There may be an odd one even there. But to keep the old sawmill running, we are going to have to get a new area of land. We'll also get some new trees replanted in this area so they can start growing as well. So yeah, next job will be to get the plough hooked up and then get our new fields ploughed in. Before we actually plough in the new field, I just want to get rid of a couple of piles of stones out the way. And actually, in the way, but if we do want to extend the field around this little bit area, we're better off getting them moved. So there's the couple of poles here, there's that one there, another one there, and I think that's it for down here. I don't think there's any more slot off cut of wood I've missed, but I chucked out the way. Let's drop that on there so I know where it is. Yeah, there's two piles of stones there we can get out the way. That one there's not in the way, but we'll probably clear it anyway and break it up. And that one as well. Then we can get the stones out. And this one here. So if we jump into the massive, I can find it. We'll get these broken up first. We've got the bucket here for the wheel loader, so we can pick the stones up and just clear them out the way. That way then we can just extend the field into this area a little bit, and we'll probably just come up to the edge of these trees and bushes. Give us a bit more space for this one field. That's the first pile broke up. Second one done. So I'll get the others two done, then we can get these cleared up out the way. The stones all picked up out of the way, I'm just going to pile them up where this smaller pile is here for now, until we get a trailer to load these all up into. So the next job before we get the field ploughed in is just to extend that track a little bit, and also work out roughly where we're going to put the dividing for the two fields. So I'll probably just mark that with a landscaping tool so I know where to blow up to. So if we go into the landscape build mode, I'll go painting. And what I want to do first is just extend this track a little bit so we know where we're following. I'm going to bring it just around the edge of this grass area. And also now we want to try and work out, I think that's probably not far off where we want to be splitting the field. But sort of across there, so I think we'll probably bring it to there. Now that way then we can access this second field and this field here without having to drive all the way around. So if we jump back into the John Deere now, we can get these two fields plowed in. I'll do the divide first, so we'll start off in the middle, get the one field done and then do the second one. If we start somewhere over this way, I might need to just bring that track over a little bit because it's a bit of on a slope there where it's a bit more flat. I'll turn on allow crate fields and then I'll get this drop down. So I'll bring the second field around this way and kind of go off. So we get that to around there. Head for the middle of those two poles. And we shouldn't be too far off then. I think this end may be slightly bigger, but that's not going to matter too much if one's slightly larger than the other. So now it's just a case of getting these both ploughed in. And then that'll be, get those ready for next time when we'll be into October and we can get some barley into one of them for the next harvest. Okay, so that's both of our new fields ploughed in, so they're all done. So next job next time is we'll get at least one of the fields spread with lime and then we'll get some barley sown in it. I will also tidy up the rest of these bits of equipment, get these out of the way, and I probably think next time as well we'll look at clearing the area to get the spinnery built, or at least get that area clear ready for the spinnery to be built. We've currently got, I think there's around about 4,200, 300 litres of wool from the sheep, so they are starting to produce quite a bit now, and they're not too far off reproducing as well, so we'll start doubling how many we've got. I don't think they'll start, the newborns will start producing wool until they're a certain age. Their reproduction is 80% now, so we'll be up to 100 sheep. 100 sheep, yeah. Trying to work out there. 25, 50. Yeah, 100 sheep. The chickens have also reproduced, so we're up to 150 chickens now. And when the newborns get a bit older, they'll start producing eggs as well. So that'll also increase our egg production. I'm also tempted to put grass into this field here. and change this little section of the farm to put another entrance in round to this section, so we can get round to the shed here. Looks like we still need to do a little bit of landscaping. Looks like there's a slight bump there I haven't ironed out. Yeah, so we'll probably put grass in this field next time so it can start growing. I will keep this field till next year and we'll probably put corn or soybeans in this. And then the other field that we've got over on the other side, we'll probably put oats in that one next year as well, so we can get some oats. So we'll leave this episode here. Obviously we've done quite a bit again. We've got a lot of trees cleared out the way. We've made a lot of money. Two new fields plowed in as well. And also as we've been progressing through time, the roller coaster has been working away. I'm just going to check actually before we do finish up to see where we are with the roller coaster, because we were quite far progressed on this current stage. So yeah, still quite a bit to do now. But we have everything in stock that it currently needs. So yeah, we don't need to worry about that again for a while. I just want to check the boats as well, because we are up to 329,000, so we can afford to buy the boatyard. I don't know where it is on the current stage, so it doesn't look like it's actually progressed much. So is it still missing something, or is it just slow? Yeah, it still has everything it requires for the current stage. I think it's just because we're still in the same month as we were last time. We've not quite progressed as much time as we would normally. So yeah, next time we'll be into October and we'll get the two new fields sorted out. We'll probably just get the lime spread and onto this one and get some barley sown in October so that can start growing for next year. So again, yeah, we'll leave it here. Hope you've enjoyed this episode. If you have, then please don't forget to give it a like. If you're not yet subscribed to the channel, then please do consider subscribing. We've got more Farm Simulator 22 content coming with the Let's Play series and Timelapse, and also the live streams as well. So again, a big thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one. Goodbye.